Now that we have some show information in the console, let's go through some of the basics of display navigation. To go from live summary to live table, press the format key. Let's first take a look at the live channel display. The top portion of the view has all of our channels in it, and at the bottom, there's a ribbon which contains all of our information about our current queue. Below our tabs, near the very bottom of the screen, you'll notice that is where our command line lives. So let's start looking at different ways we can interact with this display. Right now we're in table view, and table view will take all of our channels that are single parameter, like dimmers, and show them in a small little tile, like our channels 1 through 10. You'll also notice that channels that have non-intensity parameters will display in table so that we can see all the information about those channels. If I hit my format key on the keypad, I will go into summary view, and summary view will collapse all of our tables under our channel numbers and allow us to see a lot more channels at once, but with a little less detail. Another thing I can do with my format button is press and hold the format key and roll my intensity wheel, and that will allow me to zoom in and zoom out of the channel display and find a level of zoom that's comfortable for me to work in. And this will work in either table or in summary view. We can also use our page up and page down arrows in this display. So if I use my page down, you'll notice that I am paging down a full page at a time. If I want to go line by line, I can use my scroll lock key. My scroll lock is going to allow me to page individual line by individual line. For now, I'm going to go ahead and turn that off. In the summary view, I get a lot of general information about what my channels are doing, including us rounding some values for you. So if I hit 1 through 10 and I start rolling those up, I can get to a level, and right now they're showing at 92%. But if I hold my data key, you'll notice that it will expose the real values, which is actually 91.8%. So data is a great way to show the information that's hiding behind the summary. And this will be true once we discuss palettes and presets as well. And I'm going to page down really quickly. And if you look at those channels, each of them are giving us a summary of the information happening in the different categories. So at the very top is our channel number, and you'll notice channels that are patched in white and channels that are unpatched are grayed out. Moving down in your black box is where your intensity shows up. And then below are summaries for things that are happening in your focus, color, and beam categories. We'll talk about all these when we get into parameter control. The next thing we're going to look at is the blind channel display. You'll notice on your face panel right next to your live button is our blind button. And blind takes us into the area of the desk which will allow us to look at what we've recorded that isn't actually on stage. So we can look at cues or palettes or presets all without having to put them up on stage to see their levels. When you're in blind, your next and last keys on your face panel will allow you to navigate through the targets, and we'll look at those a little bit more in a future video. Also remember that when you're in blind, a record is not required for any changes you make. Those changes are stored immediately when the command line is terminated, so just be careful in this area. To go back into live channel display, simply hit the live button on your face panel.